Good morning everyone, my name is Satyam Mishra. My topic is computer worms. In this topic we see that what are worms, difference between virus versus worms, what are their mechanism, their classification, work of payloads and the motivation, Morris worms, code red, NIMDA, SQL, slammer worms, SOBIC, F worms and preservation. So starting with the worms, so here we discuss about worms. What are worms? Worms is a program that uses computer network and security holes to replicate itself. Scans the network for another machine that has a specific security hole and copies itself. Use of computer processing time and network bandwidth during replication. Carry payloads that do considered damage. Now next, virus versus worm. Virus are the attached itself to OS, operating OS means operating system or the program. Need user action to abate their propagation. Damages caused is mostly local to the machine, spread quickly and slowly. And worms. Worms do not attach itself to operating system. They are self-propagates across the networks, exploiting security in widely used services. It harms the network and consumes network bandwidth. Separate much more rapidly. Example, SQL slammer worms, which are aware 75,000 victim with 10 minutes, which means every 10 minutes we got 75,000 victims which are affected by the slammer worms. Next, what their mechanism of operation? There are four stages. First, initial infection, which infect the host, then target acquisition. Third, delivery of versatile code, execution of versatile code or operational transfer to additional code. These are the mechanism of operation where the worms affect our system or networking programs. Next, classification. We can classify worms into four categories. First, target discovery, propagation carrier, activation and payloads. Target discovery. There are generally five methods. First, scanning pre-generated target list, externally generated target list, internal target list and passive. Scanning. Scanning entails probing a set of addresses to identify vulnerable host. Then pre-generated targeted list, generated by the worms. Third, externally generated targeted list and target list maintained on a server, which is also called meta servers. Internal target list, network based application always contain information about other host. And passive, not positively search for victim host, it waiting for potential victim contact and produces an abnormal traffic, more stealthy. Propagation carrier, there are two basic types. First, positively spread itself machine by machine, self carried, be carried along with normal communication, which have the two types, second channel and embedded. Second channel means needs second communication channel, and embedded means either appending to or replacing normal messages and very difficult to detect. Activation, human activation or slowest worm activation method. Try to conceive people by using social engineering techniques, indicating urgency, attached is an important message for you, or using people's variety, like open this message to see who loves you. These are the message where people become a victims or affected by the worms. Human activity based activation, resetting the machine or logging in or opening a remotely infected file. Third, scheduled process activation, auto updater programs, and then last, self activation or fast worm activation. These are the attached themselves to running services, like we play some online games or see online videos. So in that games or videos we got affected by the worms. Next, payload. A payload is a code is the worm designed to do more than spread the worm. They are the non-functional or Morris worm, internet remote control, code red 2, spam relay, SOBIC F, internet DOS, code red YAHA, data collection that are target on sensitive data and identify theft, data damage, erase data or physical world damage, like reflashing the BIOS or destroying the motherboards. Work of payloads. Now we see that what are the work of payloads. First, delete files, encrypt files, send documents via email, install a backdoor in the infected computer to allow the creation of the zombie computer under control of the worm author. Networks of such machine are often referred to as bayonets. Next, what are the motivation of the worms? First, experimental curiosities, Morris worms, pride, extortion and criminal gain, random protests, political protests, terrorism or cyber warfare. Then, now there are some examples of worm which I explained to you. First, Morris worm. This worm is launched on November 2, 1988 from MIT by Robert Morris, designed to spread on Unix system. 6,000 computers out of 60,000 computers at that time, that is 10%. The US GAO, GAO means Governmental Accountability Office, put the cost of the damage at $10 million to $100 million, which was the biggest damage by the bomb. He was convicted in the US under the 1986 Computer Fraud and Abuse Act. Then Code Red. Code Red is made by the huge headlines in 2001. It slowed down the internet traffic when it began to replicate itself. Worm scanned the internet for unpatched Windows NT or Windows 2000 servers. The Code Red worms had instructions to do three things. First, replicate itself for the first 20 days of each month. Second, replicate web pages featuring the message hacked by Chinese. And third, launch a concerted attack on the White House website. This information we get from the US government the US government changed the IP address of www.whitehouse.gov. Next here, NIMDA. The worm was released on September 18, 2001, the internet's most widespread virus or worm within 22 minutes. NIMDA affected both user workstation or clients running Windows 95, 98, ME, NT 2000 or XP and server running Windows NT and 2000. NIMDA is spread by 5 different infection vectors via email, via open network shares, via browsing of compromised websites, via backdoors left behind the Code Red 2 or SendMind 10, 2 worms. Next, SQL Slammer worms. Starting on January 25, 2003, it spreads rapidly, infecting most of the 75,000 victims within 10 minutes. Although titled SQL Slammer worm, the program did not use the SQL language. It exploited a buffer overflow bug in Microsoft SQL Server, Slammer's tiny 376-byte program. Next is Sobic F worms. In late 2003, the Sobic F worm exploited open proxy servers to turn infected machines into a spam engine. The Sobic worms appear as an electronic mail with one of the following subject, that is re-approved, re-detail, re-my-detail, re-thank you, or re-that movie, etc. It will contain the text, see the attached file for details, and have attachments such as application.pif or details.pif, movie0045.pif, etc. At its peak, Sobic F reportedly account for one in every 17 message. It produces more than 1 million copies of itself within in the first 24 hours. It was written using the Microsoft Visual C++ compiler. Next, prevention. Prevention means how can we prevent our computer with these worms. These are very important methods that we should follow to hide our privacy or to protect our privacy. This prevention method can protect our operating system also from worms. So, how can I prevent virus or Trojan worms and malware from getting into my system? First, careful web browsing. Then email safety, keep protection tools up to date, review software being installed and monitor your child computer usage. First, you have to update your software properly and then automatic updates are on which provides the updates for your computer which fix the bugs and which have less chances to enter the worms into our operating system. Then virus protection system like some softwares which stop the virus or stop the replication of the bombs, which helps our computer to perform better and stop these bombs to enter into our operating system. Also, we can update our system regularly at time to time, and we have to carefully browse through internet, that we don't have to go those sites which do not have security features like we have to browse carefully and do not go any sites. We have to always follow the trusted sites. So here is my presentation, and thank you for so much.